Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, happy birthday.
22nd.
Your birthday. Do din baad, acha. Acha, acha.
Thank you. Minimum 1 hour it used to take, and that's it. Yeah, that is the toughest job at this point of time. No, see, Ram Charan, this Dairo Surendar, everybody made me to work hard. So I thought, while going through the subject hearing, at the time of hearing, I thought, yeah, duplicate, double body double will take care. Now technology is available, so they can morph it or do something. But literally, these guys, they didn't compromise. They made me to fight. And I had already bad shoulder. I got operated, some rotator cuff problem to my shoulder. Even then, they made me to do with a sword fight, horse riding and everything. I did myself at this point of time. Not fair, but always I'll feel happy when doing hard work. So I'll cherish it. So really I enjoyed doing this film. And even Surekha, my wife, the presenter of this movie, she was telling me one day, so by 7 o'clock we started first shot. And at the time morning by 4, 4:30 I had to get up, do my workout for 1 hour and then getting ready and everything. So she has seen me and one day she is telling, don't do like this. Why? I said, you are getting bad to my son, Ram Charan. He said, you are so, going such a maintaining timing. The guys, they go half an hour this way, that way, and don't be so punctual. My son is getting a bad name, she said. I'm just lighter side of it, I'm telling. So I enjoyed working this movie again. And really, now I could see the result of it. Definitely, people will cherish this and they'll give you best. Yeah, I mean, voice over, you mean to say, or my character? My character. Somebody's doing.
No, sir. Hello?
Well, teaser, for teaser.
No, no, no. Both Rajni sir and Mohanlal sir are not doing. They might just, Mohanlal sir is only Malayalam. Presenting, he's giving a voice over.
Voice over Malayalam, that's what Mohanlal is giving.
Not the
and
voice.
And Telugu, my brother Pawan Kalyana, he has given. And other languages, we are requesting other stars. They might mobilize, yes. Pardon?
No, sir.
No. Kamal willing to do that. I requested him. He said, okay, now he's not feeling well. But finally, in the film, initial intro and the conclusion will be these stars' voiceover will be there. So they will tell him. That's it.
This is the last question. Thank you so much for all your questions. And thank you so much for coming here. Thank you so much for bringing this film to us. This entire ensemble which is there on stage right now. Can we please have the photo op? And can we please come forward? I'll just take the mics from you. Thank you. Get the first question for the team. The mic's coming to you.
First of all, congratulations to the entire team. This is Simran Singh here from First Post. The teaser looks epic from each and every frame. So my question to Megastar. Sir, it's good to have you back on screen. And this is the, I guess, after 1992, Aaj Ka Gundra, this is the Hindi film that we are watching. So what's the reason behind this absence, sir?
I don't know why this gap has come, because I don't get any proper content to come back again. So that might be the reason. And then of late, I stopped film acting and I went to politics. Yeah. So for 10 years I was there. And again, in 2016, I started working. So I thought with this film, I should come back to Bollywood. So that's the reason.
It's great to have you back, sir. Farhan, sir, my question is to you. And first of all, congratulations for presenting another epic movie after KGF.
Thank you very much.
So my question to you, sir, it's the film is releasing on 2nd of October, and along with your friends Hrithik Roshan's War. So what's your take on that?
Well, there's also Tiger Shroff, who's my friend.
Yeah, sure.
So let's call all my friends. No? But the fact is that, you know, I think now we should go beyond this whole thing of like two films cannot release on a day. I think there's enough screens, there's enough of an audience for two films to release on a day and do well. The people who have made that film are absolutely happy with the film that they've made. I'm sure it's a great film. We wish them all the best, as I'm sure that they wish us. And we just hope that the audiences will go in and see both films. You know, that's what we can hope for. I don't look at it in any other way beyond that.
Here at the center. Hi. My name is Anketa and I'm from Republic. First of all, amazing teaser and I got goosebumps. So congratulations to all the team for that. My question to you is, Chiranjeevi ji, aapse. You know, two mega stars together coming for the first time, Chiranjeevi ji and Amitabh Bachchan together. How was it on the sets? Too much of talent flowing, I can say?
He's my real life mentor, and it happened even in the film. And I feel there is only one and only megastar, that is Amitabh Bachchan. That is nobody's
so
near to him. So I don't consider, but thank you. You mentioned that. And working with him is an amazing experience. So I'm really indebted to him a lot, because just as when my director wanted him to be my guru in this film. So that character is a special character. So he insisted me, if it is Amitabh Bachchan, nothing like that. I said, I try. I just called him. I want to talk to him. No, tell me please what you want. I want you to be in my film. Ram Charan is making this Saira, and it's a wonderful subject. And I want you to be my guru character. It's a special character. Maybe maximum 1 week time will take. He said immediately, Chiranjeevi, you don't ask anything, you never ask anything. Since you are asking, I said, I'll say yes. And he, so great. And immediately he responded. He said, send your team to me. I want to discuss the rest of the things. And I sent director and other people, I sent them. And immediately he said yes. I'm so happy, really, my heartfelt thanks to the Indian megastar, Amitabh Bachchanji.
Thank you so much, sir. I think it'll be a treat to watch both of you together. Thank you.
Hi, Ritesh. Ritesh here. There's a question for you. You got us, you know, you guys got us KGF, and you presented the entire film in a grand way, and now you guys are part of this grand film. So what's the selection process? How do you guys select, you know, these films? And secondly, will we see you producing a South Indian film, a collaboration, you know, in a big way with Hindi film actors and this some presenting in a much grander way?
Like I said, firstly, I think the content, when Charan, Anil spoke to us, and Charan had this idea of, you know, taking the film beyond just the South market and the South languages. I saw the trailer and like the teaser which you're seeing now. I think it's a story which was of an unsung hero. It's like the first rebel against the British, set in the 18th century. So I really liked what I saw. And then he took me through, I had not seen the film at that point, he took me through what the film was, and I saw various portions of it, and I was completely like in love with it. And I said, okay, this is something we should do. And I was glad that he, you know, like chose us to actually present the film. So it worked the other way. After seeing the material, we were really hopeful that he'll say that you guys should present it. So thank you. But that was there. And yes, why not? If we get a script and we can collaborate on a film which right from the script level, rather than just coming on, we are completely open to that.
Hi, Farhan. On your left. On your left. Hi. Hi. Faridun from Balunangama. So Farhan, you're saying that there are enough screens that we have. See, we are having around 5,000 screens for Hindi. And you've experienced it with Rais and...
Right. I think your question is very detailed. You should ask Anil Thadani this question.
Okay. I think I can ask both of you and Ritesh as well. I think Anil Thadani can answer as well. So the idea is that even with Rais and Kabil came together, so there was a day when I think you guys had around 26 crores in a day, and it was running to capacity. If there were more screens, you could have done more business. We've seen in Mission Mangal and Batla House, Mission Mangal Sunday was extraordinary. But if more screens were there, the business would have been higher. So what efforts do you think should be done to just raise the number of screens? Because China is way ahead of us and we are just not doing enough maybe.
You have multiple questions in your first question, huh? So we'll have to think.
And you've also answered it in your question.
No, but I think ultimately you guys will have to take the initiative. We can say, but the initiative has to come from you guys.
See, regarding the theatres, you're absolutely right. It is something we've, when we went and met our government recently, just before the elections, and when the GST issue was there, and we went and spoke to them, and I think they have understood what happens with cinemas, and what, especially in your rural city towns, because there are, either we are over-screened in Mumbai city and Delhi, where you'll have more screens, and there are a lot of places where we don't have screens. Yeah. So I think they've understood that. And like China, like you're absolutely right, China and India were on par till 2011, when we had the same average number of screens for the population, and they have obviously grown a lot. So I think, yes, there is a plan in place, but again, when you are talking about Rais or you're talking about Kabil, which released the same day, I think both were good films. If somebody went and saw Kabil on Thursday, they went and saw Rais the next day. So it's not that I did not get tickets and there was one box office you mentioned was 25 crores and the other was... I think as long as both films are something which they want to watch, they'll go and watch it. It's not that because I've seen one, I won't see the other. Right? So I don't think we have that issue of worrying, like even what Farhan said earlier, both will be good films, people will want to watch both. I mean, I'm sure you must have gone to in a week and watched two movies, right? You wouldn't only go to one film if they were there.
It's so also I don't accessibility. Think many a times people want to watch it, but the cinema screens are there, especially in the smaller cities, as you've rightly said.
Yeah,
the,
but you can go next day.
The cinema
day,
screens are less. They're not enough cinema screens maybe, and because of that, people are unable to see it.
I think they'll watch it the next day, and if it's not available on that screen, I'm sure it'll be available. It's not that it's never happened that in the same town or in the same pin code, you'll not find another screen. I don't think that's ever happened. So it's, at the most, you'll be a little more of effort. And I think if the movie is that exciting, you'll put in that little extra effort till we can have more screens like China. Right?
So Mr. Tarani, you'd like to say something to that?
So I think the capacities actually come into play only for that one day, which is a holiday. The rest of the weekdays, there is ample room for two or maybe even three films to survive. So yeah, but if there were more screens, it would be better. So I think that's for the exhibitors to answer that question.
Who's next? Sure.
Congratulations to the entire team. The trailer is superb. It looks fantastic. My question is to Tamanna. Tamanna, how does it really feel to be on the center and all among all the great men? You have been quite lucky to do Bahubali, now such a big film again. What's your experience?
I'd really like to first of all thank Suri sir, Surinder Reddy, who's sitting here. मैं इनके साथ इसके पहले काम कर चुकी हूँ एंड जब भी उन्होंने मुझे किसी भी किरदार के लिए बुलाया है हमेशा कुछ अलग करने के लिए बुलाते हैं एंड फॉर मी इट वाज ऑलवेज अ ड्रीम सिंस आई एंटर्ड द साउथ इंडियन फिल्म इंडस्ट्री कि कब मैं चिरंजीवी सर के साथ काम करूँगी एंड वो इस फिल्म से पूरा हो रहा है आई कांट आस्क फॉर मोर बिकॉज जब एक टीज़र में एक अपना ऐसा शॉट देखती हूँ तो लगता है अगर ये ही एक शॉट होता मेरा फिल्म में तो भी मेरे लिए काफ़ी है तो थैंक यू चिरू सर फॉर मेकिंग मी अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस फिल्म इट्स एक्सट्रीमली स्पेशल एंड चरण आई वर्क विथ हिम यू नो ही इज़ पुट इन हिज हार्ट एंड सोल टू सी दिस प्रोजेक्ट कम टू लाइफ एंड यू नो गेट एवरीथिंग दैट इट नीड्स आई ऑल्सो वुड रियली रियली लाइक टू मैंशन सुष्मिता हु हैज़ डन द कॉस्ट्यूम्स फॉर द फिल्म हमने काफ़ी काम किया हर एक लुक के लिए शी इज़ सिटिंग राइट हियर शी इज़ रियली लाइक जब मैं मिरर में देखती थी तो मुझे लगता था कि हाँ दिस इज़ लक्ष्मी सो दैट्स वॉट शी मेड मी फील ऑन द सेट एंड मेरा अपना किरदार निभाना बहुत आसान हो गया क्योंकि मैं पहले ही लक्ष्मी जैसे दिख रही थी तो फिर ऑन सेट आई फेल्ट लाइक लक्ष्मी एंड या एवरी ईच एंड एवरी वन हु इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ द फिल्म आई वर्क विद विजय रवि सर के साथ कभी काम हमने काम किया नहीं हमने कभी काम नहीं किया साथ में किया है नहीं इनको इतने बार देखा कि ऐसे लग रहा है कि इनके साथ भी काम किया है
हम नहीं मुझे शायद पहले
पहले बहुत पहले
बहुत पहले
बहुत पहले so it's just such a huge cast and thank you guys you made this possible I think for getting this film presenting it to the Hindi audiences who better than you guys to bring this this really really amazing story out there to the Hindi audiences so yeah I mean it's like a dream come true
yeah Farhan and Ritesh after KGF like you become more confident like you know like after success of KGF you become more confident to bring more regional film in to Bollywood
No, it's not really a question of more or less confidence. I mean, you eventually believe in what it is that you are, what you have lying in front of you. So the way this film has been put together, just really the vision behind it is something that gives us a lot of confidence. And the belief that the core team has in the film, the way that they really have cut no corners in presenting it and making it an absolutely riveting, entertaining piece for the viewers, that gives you confidence. So it's not about what you've done before, what you're going to do in the future. It really is about just this film.
Hi, Ram. Firstly, kindly walk us through your character in the film. And secondly, why are you shying away from Hindi films? We want to see you in Hindi films. What's the reason for that?
Hi. My part is just being a producer. I've not done anything apart from that. I want to take the opportunity to thank all this great stars and cast we had put together. It wouldn't have been possible if it's not my dad and the love they have for him and they wanted to be part of this journey, which is his dream project. And they all recognize that and it is very kind of all the artists here to help me and put this cast together. And secondly, I've not shied away. I'm not really, like dad said, it's all about the content. Coming with the right content matters a lot, end of the day, for any actor. And hopefully next year, I'm coming back with Rajmouli Garu's next project after, right now we're shooting for that. Hopefully that'll be my comeback, RRR.
Well, best wishes for that. And Sudeep, you are working with, you're working with this film with so many megastars and you know this is a grand film which is coming next month and then you will be having Dabang 3 with Salman Khan. So this year is like a superstar year for you.
You said it yourself. So I guess made my answer easy. One is we should always be lucky to be a part of a fraternity like film industry which showcases us in different parts where we do not actually belong. Second, connection to such people whom we have seen growing up. Wonderful, I mean, it's as I said, properties are one side in Saira. Actors are also equally as many as properties. So many, you know. Actually, I don't know whether there were any kind of vanity vans or any cars left in Hyderabad when we went. There are certain times in this particular set, sir. Set was only a very small one. I mean, of course, after the extension, it will be much bigger. But we had to pass a huge traffic to reach there from the gate, you know. That was something by itself, you know, where we are heading. So, you know, kind of you start getting mentally prepared where we are going. And once you go there, I guess the platform, the producers, and especially Ram, I mean, he's an actor himself, I guess, and if somebody should have a son, they should have like him, you know, who can make his father's dream come true to such an extent. It is lovely, sir, to be called. Yeah, we all have our own platforms where we belong, but stepping out of that, coming here, doing something because somebody else needs you, and trying to be submissive towards somebody's dream is much more fulfilling than what we dream ourselves. Same thing goes with Dabang 3 also. So I guess it's been a beautiful thing that you're wanted everywhere and you're called.
I have a question here.
Thank you.
live away early 90s. So till 2007, I was in the film field only. So after that, I stopped acting. Again, I entered 2016. In this 10 years time, lot of change I have seen in there in the films. And when I'm leaving, there was a negative and positive clapboard and all these things. Nowadays, there's no such things are existing. So I felt when I'm doing my, when I was doing my 150th film, as a newcomer doing the first film, it was a different atmosphere, different scenario, even at the time of exhibitions, I mean, in the theaters also. Totally, film has gone, projectors have gone. And that could change, but the content, the sentiment, it doesn't change at all. I trust the emotion of the film, the soul of the film carries from ages to even now, and it goes on like that. That change I didn't find. Only physical appearance, physical changes I've seen, but not the content. That's good.
Could we get the first question for the team? The mic's coming to you.
First of all, congratulations to the entire team. This is Simran Singh here from First Post. The teaser looks epic from each and every frame. So my question to Megastar. Sir, it's good to have you back on screen. And this is the, I guess, after 1992, Aaj Ka Gundra, this is the Hindi film that we are watching. So what's the reason behind this absence, sir?
I don't know why this gap has come, because I don't get any proper content to come back again. So that was the reason. And then of late, I stopped film acting and I went to politics. Okay. So for 10 years, I was there. And again, in 2016, I started working. So I thought with this film, I should come back to Bollywood. So that's the reason.
It's great to have you back, sir. Farhan, sir, my question is to you. And first of all, congratulations for presenting another epic movie after KGF.
Thank you very much.
So my question to you, sir, it's the film is releasing on 2nd of October, and along with your friends, Hrithik Roshan's War. So What's your take on that?
Well, there's also Tiger Shroff, who's my friend. So let's call all my friends. But the fact is that, you know, I think now we should go beyond this whole thing of like two films cannot release on a day. I think there's enough screens, there's enough of an audience for two films to release on a day and do well. The people who have made that film are absolutely happy with the film that they've made. I'm sure it's a great film. We wish them all the best, as I'm sure that they wish us. And we just hope that the audiences will go in and see both films. You know, that's what we can hope for. I don't look at it in any other way beyond that.
Here at the center. Hi. My name is Anketa and I'm from Republic. First of all, amazing teaser. And I got goosebumps. So congratulations to all the team for that. My question to you is, Chiranjeevi ji, aap se. You know, two mega stars together coming for the first time. Chiranjeevi ji and Amitabh Bachchan together. How was it on the sets? Too much of talent flowing, I can say?
He is my real life mentor. And it happened even in the film. And I feel there is only one and only megastar, that is Amitabh Bachchan. That is nobody's
so
near to him. So I don't consider, but thank you. You mentioned that, and working with him is an amazing experience. So I'm really indebted to him a lot, because just I asked when my director wanted him to be my guru in this film. So that character is a special character. So he insisted me, if it is Amitabh Bachchan, nothing like that. I said, I try. I just called him. I want to talk to him. No, no, tell me please what you want. I want you to be in my film. Ramchand is making this Saira, and it's a wonderful subject. And you are, I want you to be my guru character. It's a special character. Maybe maximum 1 week time will take. He said immediately, Chiranjeevi, you don't ask anything. You never ask anything. Since you are asking, I said, I'll say yes. And he, so great. And immediately he responded. He said, send your team to me. I want to discuss the rest of the things. And I sent director and other people. I sent them. And immediately he said, yes. I'm so happy, really, my heartfelt thanks to the Indian megastar, Amitabh Bachchanji.
Thank you so much, sir. I think it'll be a treat to watch both of you together. Thank you.
Hi, Ritesh. Ritesh here. There's a question for you. You got us, you know, you guys got us KGF, and you presented the entire film in a grand way, and now you guys are part of this grand film. So what's the selection process? How do you guys select, you know, these films? And secondly, will we see you producing a South Indian film, a collaboration, you know, in a big way with Hindi film actors and this some presenting in a much grander way?
Like I said, firstly, I think the content when Charan, Anil spoke to us, and Charan had this idea of, you know, taking the film beyond just the South market and the South languages. I saw the trailer and like the teaser which you're seeing now. I think it's a story which was of an unsung hero. It's like the first rebel against the British set in the 18th century. So I really liked what I saw. And then he took me through, I had not seen the film at that point. He took me through what the film was and I saw various portions of it and I was completely like in love with it, and I said, okay, this is something we should do, and I was glad that he, you know, like chose us to actually present the film. So it worked the other way. After seeing the material, we were really hopeful that he'll say that you guys should present it. So thank you, but that was there. And yes, why not? I mean, if we get a script and we can collaborate on a film which right from the script level rather than just coming on, we are completely open to that.
Hi Farhan, on your left. On your left, hi. Hi, Faridun from Balunangama. So Farhan, you're saying that there are enough screens that we have. See, we are having around 5,000 screens for Hindi. And you've experienced it with Rais and...
Right, I think your question is very detailed. You should ask Anil Thadani this question.
Okay, I think I can ask both of you and Ritesh as well. I think Anil Thadani can answer as well. So the idea is that even with Rais and Kabil came together, so there was a day when I think you guys had around 26 crores in a day, and it was running to capacity. If there were more screens, you could have done more business. We've seen it in Mission Mangal and Batla House. Mission Mangal Sunday was extraordinary, but if more screens were there, the business would have been higher. So what efforts do you think should be done to just raise the number of screens, because China is way ahead of us and we are just not doing enough maybe?
You have multiple questions in your first question, huh? So we'll have to think.
And you've also answered it in your question.
No, but I think ultimately you guys will have to take the initiative. We can say, but the initiative has to come from you guys.
You know, see, regarding the theatres, you're absolutely right. It is something we've, when we went and met our government recently, just before the elections, and when the GST issue was there, and we went and spoke to them, and I think they have understood what happens with cinemas. And what, especially in your rural city towns, because there are, either we are over-screened in Mumbai city and Delhi, where you'll have more screens, and there are a lot of places where we don't have screens. Yeah. So I think they've understood that. And like China, like you're absolutely right, China and India were on par till 2011 when we had the same average number of screens for the population, and they have obviously grown a lot. So I think, yes, there is a plan in place, but again, when you are talking about Rais or you're talking about Kabil, which released the same day, I think both were good films. If somebody went and saw Kabil on Thursday, they went and saw Rais the next day. So it's not that I did not get tickets, and there was one box office you mentioned was 25 crores and the other was... I think as long as both films are something which they want to watch, they'll go and watch it. It's not that because I've seen one, I won't see the other. Right? So I don't think we have that issue of worrying, like even what Farhan said earlier, both will be good films, people will want to watch both. I mean, I'm sure you must have gone to in a week and watched two movies, right? You wouldn't only go to one film if they were there.
It's also about accessibility. Many a times people want to watch it, but the cinema screens are, especially in the smaller cities, as you've rightly said.
Yeah, but you can go next day.
The cinema screens are less. They're not enough cinema screens, maybe, and because of that, people are unable to see it.
So I think they'll watch it the next day, and if it's not available on that screen, I'm sure it'll be available. It's not that it's never happened that in the same town or in the same pin code, you'll not find another screen. I don't think that's ever happened. So it's, at the most, you'll be a little more of effort. And I think if the movie is that exciting, you'll put in that little extra effort till we can have more screens like China, right?
So Mr. Tarani, you'd like to say something to that?
So I think the capacities actually come into play only for that one day, which is a holiday. The rest of the weekdays, there is ample room for two or maybe even three films to survive. So. Yeah, but if there were more screens, it would be better. So I think that's for the exhibitors to answer that question.
Who's next? Sure. That's
okay. Congratulations to the entire team. The trailer is superb. It looks fantastic. My question is to Tamanna. Tamanna, like, how does it really feel to be on the center and all among all the great men? You have been quite lucky to do Bahubali, now such a big film again. What's your experience?
I'd really like to first of all thank Suri sir, Surinder Reddy, who's sitting here. Main inke saath iske pehle kaam kar chuki hoon, and. जब भी उन्होंने मुझे किसी भी किरदार के लिए बुलाया है हमेशा कुछ अलग करने के लिए बुलाते हैं एंड फॉर मी इट वाज ऑलवेज अ ड्रीम सिंस आई एंटर्ड द साउथ इंडियन फिल्म इंडस्ट्री कि कब मैं चिरंजीवी सर के साथ काम करूंगी एंड वो इस फिल्म से पूरा हो रहा है आई कांट आस्क फॉर मोर बिकॉज जब एक टीज़र में एक अपना ऐसा शॉट देखती हूँ तो लगता है अगर ये ही एक शॉट होता मेरा फिल्म में तो भी मेरे लिए काफ़ी है तो थैंक यू चिरू सर फॉर मेकिंग मी अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस फिल्म इट्स एक्सट्रीमली स्पेशल एंड चरण आई वर्कड विथ हिम यू नो ही इज पुट इन हिज हार्ट एंड सोल टू सी दिस प्रोजेक्ट कम टू लाइफ एंड यू नो गेट एवरीथिंग दैट इट नीड्स आई ऑल्सो वुड रियली लाइक टू मैंशन सुष्मिता हु हैज़ डन द कॉस्ट्यूम्स फॉर द फिल्म हमने काफ़ी काम किया हर एक लुक के लिए शी सिटिंग राइट हियर शी इज रियली लाइक जब मैं मिरर में देखती थी तो मुझे लगता था कि हाँ दिस इज़ लक्ष्मी सो दैट्स वॉट शी मेड मी फील ऑन द सेट एंड मेरा अपना किरदार निभाना बहुत आसान हो गया क्योंकि मैं पहले ही लक्ष्मी जैसे दिख रही थी तो फिर ऑन सेट आई फेल्ट लाइक लक्ष्मी एंड एंड या एवरी ईच एंड एवरी वन हु इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ द फिल्म आई वर्क विद विजय रवि सर के साथ कभी काम हमने काम किया नहीं हमने कभी काम नहीं किया साथ में किया है नहीं इनको इतने बार देखा कि ऐसे लग रहा है कि इनके साथ भी काम किया है
हमने मुझे शायद पहले
पहले बहुत पहले बहुत पहले सो इट्स जस्ट सच अ ह्यूज कास्ट एंड थैंक यू गाइज यू मेड दिस पॉसिबल आई थिंक फॉर गेटिंग दिस फिल्म प्रेजेंटिंग इट टू द हिंदी ऑडियंसेज हु बेटर देन यू गाइज टू ब्रिंग दिस this really, really amazing story out there to the Hindi audiences. So yeah, I mean, it's like a dream come true.
Yeah, Farhan and Ritesh, after KGF, like, you become more confident, like, you know, like, after success of KGF, you become more confident to bring more regional film in to Bollywood?
No, it's not really a question of more or less confidence. I mean, you eventually believe in what it is that you are, what you have lying in front of you. So the way this film has been put together, just really the vision behind it is something that gives us a lot of confidence. And the belief that the core team has in the film, the way that they really have cut no corners in presenting it and making it an absolutely riveting, entertaining piece for the viewers, that gives you confidence. So it's not about what you've done before, what you're going to do in the future. It really is about just this film.
Hi, Ram. Firstly, kindly walk us through your character in the film, and secondly, why are you shying away from Hindi films? We want to see you in Hindi films. What's the reason for that?
Hi. My part is just being a producer. I have not done anything apart from that. I want to take the opportunity to thank all this great star cast we had put together. It wouldn't have been possible if it's not my dad and the love they have for him, and they wanted to be part of this journey, which is his dream project, And they all recognize that, and it is very kind of all the artists here to help me and put this cast together. And secondly, I've not shied away. I'm not really, like Dad said, it's all about the content. Coming with the right content matters a lot, end of the day, for any actor. And hopefully next year, I'm coming back with Rajmouli Garu's next project after, right now we're shooting for that. Hopefully that'll be my comeback, RRR.
Well, best wishes for that. And Sudeep, you are working with, you're working with this film with so many megastars, and you know, this is a grand film which is coming next month, and then you will be having Dabang 3 with Salman Khan. So this year is like a superstar year for you.
You said it yourself. So I guess made my answer easy. One is, we should always be lucky to be a part of a fraternity like film industry, which showcases us in different parts where we do not actually belong. Second, connection to such people whom we have seen growing up. Wonderful. I mean, it's as I said, properties are one side in Saira. Actors are also equally as many as properties. So many, you know. Actually, I don't know whether there were any kind of vanity vans or any cars left in Hyderabad when we went. There are certain times in this particular set, sir. Set was only a very small one. I mean, of course, after the extension, it will be much bigger. But we had to pass a huge traffic to reach there from the gate, you know. That was something by itself, you know, where we are heading. So, you know, kind of you start getting mentally prepared where we are going. And once you go there, I guess the platform, the producers, and especially Ram, I mean, he's an actor himself, I guess, and if somebody should have a son, they should have like him, you know, who can make his father's dream come true to such an extent. It is lovely, sir, to be called. Yeah, we all have our own platforms where we belong, but stepping out of that, coming here, doing something because somebody else needs you, and trying to be submissive towards somebody's dream is much more fulfilling than what we dream ourselves. Same thing goes with Dabang 3 also. So I guess it's been a beautiful thing that you're wanted everywhere and you're called.
I have a question here.
Early 90s. So till 2007, I was in the film field only. So after that, I stopped acting. Again, I entered 2016. In this 10 years time, lot of change I have seen in the films. And when I'm leaving, there was a negative and positive clapboard and all these things. Nowadays, there's no such things are existing. So I felt when I'm doing my, when I was doing my 150th film, as a newcomer doing the first film, it was a different atmosphere, a different scenario, even at the time of exhibitions, I mean, in the theaters also. Totally, film has gone, projectors have gone. And that could change, but the content, the sentiment, it doesn't change at all. I trust the emotion of the film, the soul of the film carries from ages to even now, and it goes on like that. That change I didn't find. Only physical appearance, physical changes I've seen, but not the content. Oh, that's good.
No, sir, not at all.
I'm
in talk with one movie, but I don't have any idea. Seriously, I don't have any idea. Thanks.
आप सभी से एक सवाल करना चाह रहे थे कि Hindi, South ka cinema aur Bollywood hamesha alag alag raha hai aur alag alag. Aisa kya badla hai ab? Ki wo jo diwar thi, wo toot gayi. What has changed? Logon ka nazariya ya logon ko present karne ka nazariya? Kya badla hai ki ye jo diwar thi South aur Bollywood ke filmon mein ye toot gayi hai ab?
Sorry, is your question to anybody in particular or?
Anyone can answer, like you can answer from Bollywood.
Okay, so I mean, to be honest, I didn't know of any such wall or diwar which was there between these two industries. Since the time we started making movies, Jab Dil Chahta Hai Banai, our first film, we personally thought that time people used to tell us, yaar, aap log ne jo film banai, ye bahut, it's ahead of its time. Us time India mein koi multiplexes nahi the. So, but we believed in that story, we identified with it, and so we made that film. So, I don't know about, you know, then, you know, a few years later, you start hearing, yeah, language is not a barrier anymore. So, within our own country, and I don't consider it South or Bollywood, those are not, it's one fraternity, it's one industry, it's one nation, it's one country. So, the films are one. And when we don't have boundaries for language globally, why should it exist here? Right, and I think we are all here to tell a good story in any language.
Precisely, so, that's what I'm saying. They used to be there earlier also, now also. When you come and say, ki South, say, we have this coming. So that's what my question is, that what is changing? Like, is the mindset changing or the way of telling stories is changing?
Ma'am, I also think that it's a question of curiosity from the audience. I mean, as far as talent is concerned, and I don't mean only acting talent, I mean even music talent and technical talent, there constantly has been an exchange between industries. People from Bollywood have gone and acted or worked in South films. People from the South have come and worked in Hindi films. So that's been happening all the time. Maybe with the fact that there is more space for people to experience content right now, there is a hunger for wanting to see more and more things. And that has created a certain curiosity, I guess, to know what is happening in different markets within our country itself. So it's an interesting time, and it's good that this should happen. We should be constantly be exposed to other cultures, to other people's ideas, to other creativity. You'll get to constantly learn something from somebody else's passion for their work. And the audiences will always be entertained if the work is good. So that's how I see it. But it is, I think, the fact that there is a hunger for content, which over time, because of avenues of consuming it having increased, that I feel that this, what you're seeing now, that there's more exchange happening between industries.
Hi, towards your left, here. Ankita from Republic again. My question is to the captain of the ship, Mr. Suren Reddy. First of all, films like KGF, films like Bahubali have set a benchmark. Was it a challenge and a responsibility for you to, you know, make this film a notch higher?
It's a challenge for me.
And of course, having an ensemble cast and mega stars like Chiranjeevi ji and Amitabh Bachchan ji, how was it on the sets?
Yeah, I feel they're very comfortable for me. Though they create comfortable everything, so that's why I'm easy to work. Legends like, these are all big legends for me. So I'm happy to everyone, because this much big project, they give it to me. So thanks to everyone.
Congratulations for the teaser.